Okay, second part of the verse is going to be, I'll play through it. And that leads us into our chorus. So what have we got there? We'll go through them slowly. We've got B, A, D, G, B minor, A, G for a bar. All right, if you have trouble following through that at all, make sure you've got the chart that I gave you the link for. That'll help you get through this. So from there, we're into the big chorus. Bring out the violins. Starting off on D, I'll play through it first. So we have D, F sharp minor, so second, fourth, fourth, second, 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 with the bar chord, G, D, A. So that's two times through, and then we get G for a bar, B minor, A. So G, the very first time we just get single strums on the B minor and A. On future choruses further into the song, it just keeps on strumming through. So that'd be So you notice this strumming is pretty consistent all the way through. From there, we're back into the intro section. Nothing different there, exactly the same as the intro. So you could sort of think of that as a pre-verse, a lead into your verse. From here, we get the second verse, we get your next chorus, a little solo section, again, is just the intro, like I just played there. And then from there, we get the bridge or middle eight, whichever you want to call it, same thing. So this is going to be B minor, G, D, A. We're going to get that two times through, so B minor, G, D, A. Try that through with me, same strumming pattern. Cool. From there, we're into the big sort of detour section, which has these kind of big hits, which is B minor, G, D, A. So all I'm getting there is big down, up, down, and then just keeping my groove going with chuckers, just muting those strings. You can do nothing if you want, but if you're playing a solo version, you want to keep it going. So from the B minor, down, up, down, G, D, A, normal. Cool. From there, we have B minor, A, G for a bar. Build up there, so we get two times of that. We're into our chorus once again, and then the little tag section that comes after that, the G for a bar, B minor, A. Except this time, that's gonna be three times through, and all of this is on the chart there, so you can check all of that out for the form. And then we end with just the intro, that's it. There's all our sections. So, if you get over those initial hurdles, if you can play the intro, you should pretty much be able to play the whole thing apart from maybe just that F-sharp bar if you're new to getting into your bar chords. So as I said, check out the lessons that I've got especially for the chords there to help you out with those specific things. As for the rhythm, break it down, wind it back, do it slow. This stuff takes time and it's sort of a long rhythm, so it takes a little bit to get that into your mind and on autoplay, if you think of it that way. So check out the other lesson that I have for Taylor Swift Mine. I reckon you'll like that one as well if you like this one. And as well as that, get those free drum tracks that I was telling you about. Really, really key for getting your playing solid is playing along with a rock solid drummer, and it's completely free for you. And check out all the other lessons that I've got for you. I've got plenty of skills lessons like the chord changes that I mentioned and the chord lessons over at Now Guitar Skills. It's all about being able to, you know, do this stuff yourself. That's what I want to help you be able to do. So these song lessons help you get things going straight away. But if you really want to get good at guitar, check out the skills channel, because that's the real, you know, the long run game of getting yourself really good at guitar so you can learn songs yourself. So enough of all of that. I'll catch you for another lesson really, really soon. And have fun playing your guitar. Check out the Nail Guitar channel to learn more songs. And check out my other channels for heaps of free guitar training videos. If you're on Facebook or Twitter, you can catch me there also.